that anyway to tell me that you're gonna be a terrible friend. You remind me of a distant constellation, the way you cover it up with a little touch, and I wanna know, is that important? Maybe now it just depends, it just depends. Remember not to look for me there. I give you one more chance to make it better, but you don't seem to care. You pretend to be accosted by tradition, and now you cover it up, but tell me you don't. And now you wanna know, is nothing sacred? But I don't wanna have to compare, but don't compare.
...16-inch radials, the new nanoprene.
Don't blow smoke up my rump, okay? If I don't hear 1,000 more units, I'm gonna screw.
Yeah, let me just, I can check on the load index on that for you. You know, it looks like it's, what's that? No, everything, we recycle every tire.
Okay, now we are talking. All right, let me just,
You know, we've also got,
pull up the paperwork here, we'll get you squared away.
Your store needs product, right? So what's the problem?
It's about safety. About safety for your family, for your customers. I mean, that's the bottom line. You know, these are the safest tires on the road. You know that. I'm not trying to bullshit you.
You did the right thing.
Bye. Butch, mark one up for me, please. 3 this morning.
One more for Mike, baby.
How can we be out of donuts? I mean, it's ridiculous.
And the coffee machine's busted.
Where are they? Hey. Ladies, 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 we have a very serious problem here. We're out of donuts. Jane, maybe you could get one of your girls on it ASAP.
And the coffee machine's busted.
And the coffee machine's busted.
These guys are such a-holes. Just, no, excuse me.
I already checked it. It's fried. You might want to just call the company.
Oh, look.
Oh.
Where are those donuts? Oh.
Thanks, Jane. You're the best. High five? Nope. Low five. Help. Thank you. Thank you, Jane.
You gotta be kidding me.
So she's a dream girl, right?
Nope. She reminded me of my dad.
Ken.
Hey. Oh, well, well. I'm surprised you two even show up to these sales meetings.
How you doing, Kenny?
It's Ken, dickhead. And, I know you've been fudging the numbers.
He knows we've been fudging the numbers.
Fuck you, Castro. Our numbers are legit. But we know you shit your pants at last year's Christmas party.
Dude, that's disgusting.
I didn't... Really, it wasn't like a full-on. It was a dribble. It was everybody does it. It was a mistake. I had bad sushi, and I sharted. Part was intentional, but I didn't...
I'm Bob Riley, owner and CEO of Riley Auto Parts. At Riley, we carry only the highest quality names like Goodyear, Firestone, and Michelin.
Freeze! Now, what's wrong with this commercial? Lights! Come on! He doesn't mention Treadline!
Mr. Farrell? Someone was messing with my chair, so it's stuck in the down position. So, if I seem... petite, then that is the reason.
Will someone get him a booster seat?
Now, R&D and manufacturing have done their job. Now,
it's up to us in sales to get these tires on the shelves.
Can you take notes
closed
for me?
Closed deals with AutoZone, Pep Boys, and just tires. Now we're going after bigger fish. Riley Auto Parts. One last piece of business here. It has come to my attention that some sick individual in our sales department has been spreading pornographic emails of a homosexual nature.
Kenny, Castro, Castro.
Right? You're right.
No, it wasn't. No, I didn't. It wasn't me. It wasn't. I didn't do that. They're trying to say it was me, but it wasn't. I was the. I didn't. I wouldn't. I, that's if it wouldn't be gay. I was the. I mean, I do, I mean, I wouldn't even do regular porno, but if I did, it would be regular, is my point.
Come on, Kenny, get your hands out of your pants and put an end to it. Now, I expect everyone in this room to step up their effort. Come on, let's get out there and kick some ass and make this the best sales quarter ever.
Yeah, we'll get it.
The phone. Let's do it.
All right, Steve. So let me tell you why you need these tires in the stores, okay? It's about safety. Seriously, I wouldn't let, you know, let babies roll down hills in these things.
Tire sizes? Bro, you're asking a lot of complicated questions. Yeah, I work here.
Yeah, we have maintenance. Believe me, this tire will leave a bigger footprint than Bigfoot, right?
You know 50 Cent? He absolutely loves our tires.
I mean, you know that. I'm not trying to bullshit you here. I mean, listen, you want to hear something crazy? I have actually rolled babies down hills in these things.
And I'm not lying. You know, just Google 50 Cent and tires. You just did? You didn't? Well, I don't know, maybe your Google's broken.
Believe me, as a senior salesman around here, let's just say I know a thing or two. Hang on. Hang on one second.
Oh,
if you could,
hey,
Joe. I'm sorry. We have a faulty air conditioning unit in the building.
It's in the pocket. That is so in the pocket.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Are you new here?
Yeah, I am. First day.
Oh, yeah, I thought so. See, because we don't actually get that many secretaries sitting here.
This is pretty much understood as, you know, in our table. I mean, we eat here every day.
And yeah, all we do is talk about sports and fishing and probably bore the hell out of you.
Yeah.
Right.
You got that? You good?
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to Treadline.
Welcome to Treadline. What are you, the official Treadline greeter?
And that's all. Treadline 6-5.
Lucky catch, McAdams. I'm surprised you didn't drop it.
Oh, like that pop fly you dropped in the third or fifth grader could have run that down.
Hey, I told you the lights got in my eyes. They got to turn the volume down on those things.
Hey, can we trade him to another team for like a keg of beer or just give him away?
You know what, Murphy? I'm so sick of you. I really am. You're about due for a beatdown, UFC style.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, then. Come on, bring it.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go.
Come on. Yeah. Let's bring it. Come on. You can do it. Come on. Another great game, guys. Hey, come on, Kenny. You're out of uniform. Tuck that shirt in. Come on.
It's just Ken, sir.
Hey, you two. Let's get out there and celebrate. I'm buying.
Hey.
Oh,
nice.
Well, what a victory. That double play was just fabulous.
Tailor made.
Hey, where are we going to go?
Flight club?
Yeah. Oh, boy, the flight club.
Hey,
Destiny,
looking good. Loving your boobs.
Thanks, Rodney.
When I was 9 years old, I knew what I was gonna do. Little bass, drums, guitar, put on a show for you.
We're so tired. Growing up, smoking Treadline.
When all the old folks said this shit gonna bring out the devil in you.
Baby. Oh, Jesus. Good morning, Lucy. Morning, Ed.
Rodney.
God knows what our neighbors think.
Oh, Ed and Lucy didn't seem to mind, trust me.
It's like you still think you're in your 20s, you know? But, honey, you're not. So get over it and grow up.
Yeah, okay. So look, obviously things got a little out of control last night, okay? And all I can say is I'm ashamed.
That's it?
I'm really ashamed.
Wow. Do me a favor. Keep it together for the engagement party this weekend. That's it. That's all I ask. Okay?
Wait. Don't be like that. Don't walk away like this, okay? I'm sorry, okay? It won't happen again. I promise. And this weekend, I'll be on my best behavior.
I know, but I always let you off so easy, yes. And you can't.
Yes, I can. What if I run down the streets naked, professing my love for you?
Don't tempt me, because I might make you do it.
Fine, do it.
I will.
Okay, good, deal.
You don't think I will?
I hope you do.
I will.
I'm ready.
My father thinks I'm crazy for marrying you.
Isn't he like on his fourth wife? That's kind of like getting marriage advice from Larry King. Come on. I'm sorry. You look pretty.
Thank you.
What are you wearing under there?
Good morning, sweetheart. How's my baby?
Hungover as shit, Mom, but thanks for asking.
Find your own place yet?
I'm working on it. I'm a little short on cash right now.
That's because you spend it all on booze and strippers.
Well, that is a pack of lies, and you know it. What kind of a man do you think I am? Just booze and strippers. It's outrageous. I'm offended.
Morning.
Hey, look who's up. Good morning, Destiny. Come on.
What can I get for you, dear?
I'll take a cup of coffee, thanks.
I rest my case.
Thank you.
It's much better than the one last week.
No, Mom, this one's a keeper.
Yeah, I know. It's not the way that you carry on your bag. It's not the last time. It's not the way. It's not the way that you wear yourself.
Destiny went back to your house?
She did indeed. I think she's still there. It's all right, though. My mom's gonna take her shopping.
Oh, that sounds terrific. We've been going there for, what, 5 years?
You know what?
You still don't know her real name?
Here's what I do know. She liked cuddling.
I wasn't just you gotta be the only guy I know who cuddles with a stripper.
Freak flag back in.
What's up with everyone here?
I don't know. Maybe somebody got fired.
Hey, Klein, what the hell's going on here?
You didn't hear about Farrell?
Hear about it? Dude, we were there.
Old man was a legend last night. He broke Flight Club's all-time lap dance record.
He's dead. Heart attack.
Does everybody else know?
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
You don't think we had anything to do with his death, do you?
Your rod and your staff.
No, no way. It's not like we forced him to do all those tequila shots.
No. He's the one who wanted to dance with the strippers.
Yeah. That's the last memory I'm gonna have of that crazy old bastard.
Shut the fuck up.
Follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord.
Now that Farrell's dead, who do you think Corporate's gonna promote?
I don't know, probably some real douche.
Looking good, Willie. Give that a little polish, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yep, when you close. Okay, good. Well, gentlemen, it's a new day, a new regime. I guess seniority has its perks, huh? And now, guess what time it is? It's payback time. See, you two have made working here a living hell for me, all right?
Pretty much did that yourself by being an asshole.
If this is about me sending that vibrator to your mom, I was totally drunk at the time. Gone.
Yeah, he was. I can vouch for that.
You sent my mother a vibrator.
Just a little one.
You leave my mother's vagina out of this!
Are we done here? I've got tires to sell.
No. We're not done, McAdams. We have only just begun. See, I haven't forgotten the humiliation that you two have put me through.
What humiliation?
Are you serious? How about that male stripper on my birthday? All right. What about when you put ecstasy in me and Klein's drinks at the company carnival?
Hey, do Mr. Hey, Castro.
Oh, Jesus! Yeah, it's not funny. That's a felony. That's a felony. All right, that's a felony. And I don't have the lab results yet, but I'm pretty sure it was one of you two who took a dump on the hood of my car last week.
Right on the way to Joe's.
Yeah, yeah, ha, ha, ha. Laugh it up. Laugh it up because the fun's over, all right? From now on, this place is gonna be run by my rules. I could fire your punk asses right now, no questions asked.
Yeah, well, then why don't you? Because if this is what it's gonna be like working for you, we're better off.
You think I'm that stupid? I fire you and you walk out of here with great big severance packages?
That sounds good to me.
I bet it does. Yeah. Well, you can kiss that wet dream goodbye because you're not being fired. Instead, you're being demoted.
Demoted? Are you kidding?
To what? Interns?
Are you gonna make us janitors?
How about secretaries? Yeah. Who's laughing now? Not you two. Right here. This is an honest, genuine laugh.
Hey, what are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm packing up my shit.
Yeah, don't you think we should talk about this?
There's nothing to talk about. Demoted to secretaries? Fuck that. We're out of here. I know exactly what you're thinking, but don't worry. Everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna grab some breakfast, charge up the old batteries, hit the pavement and find some new jobs. Everything will be hunky-dory. Who wouldn't hire us?
Let me be honest with you, gentlemen. Your resumes aren't great. It does look like you have some decent sales experience here. Is there someone I can call over at Treadline? Maybe a reference of some sort.
Reference?
Yeah, that's gonna be a bit of a problem.
Our reference sort of died.
Yeah, it's a long story.
There's drinking and strippers, and we might have inadvertently killed him.
No criminal charges have been filed.
Well, we're not sure.
No, I'm pretty sure we're in the clear.
Well, we're not totally sure. So, fingers crossed.
Get the fuck out of here.
Thank you. This sucks.
What if this is just temporary? Maybe I can fix this. A couple days, a week or two at the most, bam, we get our old jobs back.
What if you can't fix it? What if we're stuck being secretaries?
Relax. How bad can this be?
We start at 8 a.m. sharp. Finish at 6, 15-minute breaks, and half-hour lunches. I hope that's not going to be a problem.
Yeah, you know, actually, we're more on the 9-to-5 schedule. Farrell was cool with that.
Sometimes 10-to-4, depending on if we're hungover.
He's dead. You're on my schedule now, 8 a.m. No excuses. And try to look a little more professional.
I prefer comfort to professional.
Maybe you prefer my foot up your ass.
Let's motor on. We are expected to keep this break room neat and tidy at all times. Yes, we're little elves that wash the dishes in that sink. We're expected to keep the donuts stocked and the coffee fresh every morning, which is why we don't drink and eat all the coffee and the donuts. The secretaries have their own break room.
Are you kidding?
I don't think she's kidding. Isn't this a storage closet?
There's no TV in here. How are we supposed to watch SportsCenter?
There's no donuts.
No. Donut-free zone. We're all on diets.
Oh, this is bad. No donuts.
The phone system is a nightmare. The filing system is even worse. Our computers are pieces of crap, so, you know, deal with it.
Oh, and on Fridays, all the girls like to get together after work for a book club. At least that's what we tell our husbands. But we usually go to Bannigan's for a happy hour, though. In case you're ever interested.
Oh, thanks. But we actually have our own happy hour spot we go to.
Oh.
Yeah. One that has half-naked women swinging around on poles, which is awesome. Well, not just on poles. They kind of hang on all fours. If you're into that sort of thing, which we're not, so we only go for the buffet.
Oh, I'm sure. Well, I think it's time for you to meet your new bosses.
Well, you know as well as I do, anything that's going to boost production is going to make me happy as a clam. You got it, Chuck. Yeah. Hey, let me call you back in a little bit, you old son of a bitch. All right.
Mr. Frank, I'd like to introduce you to Rodney McAdams, your new secretary.
No thanks, sweetheart. Tell Kenny that the manufacturing department would like someone who's just a little bit more perky on top, if you know what I mean.
Well, I do, Mr. Frank. I know exactly what you mean. Yeehaw. But unfortunately, Mr. Castro has asked that Rodney be assigned to you. So, happy trails.
Well, I have a seat, Nancy.
Actually, it's Rodney, sir.
Yeah, whatever. Male secretary, huh? Shit, you might as well just have your balls cut off.
Can I help you?
Hey, sister. Wrong office. I've already been assigned to this guy.
Excuse me?
This guy's covered. All set. You better go find yourself another boss. Will you grab me a cup of coffee while you're out there, while I'm waiting around for this a-hole?
Oh, good. You're both here. Mike Murphy, meet Elizabeth Holland, your new boss.
By the way, this a-hole likes her coffee black. No sugar.
Thanks.
So who'd you get?
Some outside accountant corporate's brought in to audit the books.
Yeah.
Dude, what the fuck?
Hey, Castro, you guys kidding?
Oh, oopsie-doopsie. Sorry, guys. I'm afraid there's no more room.
What's going on?
No. Castro, we always sit here, okay? Everybody knows this is our table.
Oh, yeah? Is that right? Well, guess what? Not anymore. Because maybe I'd like to sit here once in a while. Yeah, why don't you go sit with the secretaries? You know, where you belong.
Go on, you'll fit right in.
Oh, one other thing. I'm gonna have to ask you to turn in your softball uniforms.
You're gonna kick us off the team?
Yeah.
What, is everybody on board with this? What about you, Klein, huh? What did he offer you to stab us in the back? A pay raise, your own private parking spot?
Parking spot.
How about you, O'Donnell? What'd you get? A hand job?
Look. Klein and O'Donnell are smart men. They know who signs the paychecks. Yeah? I mean, sure as shit don't want to end up like you two. And, I don't think they're alone. See, certain people around here have had to put up with you clowns because they had to. Because you were Farrell's golden boys. Well, guess what? That old fucker's dead. That makes you just my bitches.
You cannot turn this entire company against us, Castro.
Oh, yeah? Well, I can sure as hell try, McAdams. Now, why don't you two beat it before I have you restocking the tampon machines? Ta-da! Yeah, bye-bye.
Toodaloo.
Enjoy the Salisbury steak. Don't let it hit you on the ass, but in the door, I mean, if you're going out.
Hey, ladies. How's it going?
Our table's a bit crowded today. You mind if we join you?
Oh, I'm saving these for somebody.
You boys don't want to sit here anyway. All we do is talk about makeup and diets. We'd probably bore the hell out of you. Mm-hmm. Don't cry. They should cry.
Now they get to see what it feels like. Mm-hmm. They did the same thing to everybody else, and now they get a taste of their own medicine.
This blows. It's not great.
You'd never met me, not seen me before, but you knew all about me when I walked in the door. You had me figured, yeah, you knew I'm the kind of boy go crazy.
Let's face it, Castro's got us by the balls.
It's true.
Oh, shit. It's Jennifer's dad and his teen bride.
I know. I'm gonna get you one. Encore. Sir.
Mr. Daniels looking dapper as usual.
Rodney, at the bar as usual.
Hi, cutie.
How you doing?
Good.
Good. You're looking good.
Really good. Stop by fucking my wife, son.
JR.
Sure. What the hell's the matter with you?
Good to see you, Mr. Daniels.
What a prick. Are you absolutely certain you want to marry into that?
After all the shit that's gone down, JR is just the start of my problems.
What about you?
You're just as screwed as I am. You still live with your parents.
I do not live with my parents. I live in an apartment which they happen to live above.
You live in their basement.
It's not their basement, okay? It's my basement, subterranean loft.
Rodney?
Mr. Daniels?
You know, Rodney, I didn't come in here because I needed to take a whiz.
You didn't?
No, I didn't. I thought it was time I had a little chit-chat with my future son-in-law.
You mind giving me a little second to finish up here?
Look at me, Rodney.
Sir, I'd really rather not. You've got your thing going on over there, I got my thing.
I said look at me.
Jesus.
Look at it!
What?
I said look at it. I said don't you dare look me in the eyes. Look at it! Don't you look me in the eyes, I said. Look at it.
This is crazy.
You want to see crazy, son? Look at it!
Okay,
both
okay.
Eyes. Both eyes. Yeah, don't you look up. Don't you even think about looking up. That's it. You keep staring at it. You want to be a real man? You start by studying. A real man.
That's right. Take it all in. Pretty impressive. Huh? You know the sad part, son? You're smart enough to be running that place. But what have you done there? At that little tire company.
Last summer, they were thinking about giving me my own parking space.
Just like I thought. You haven't done shit, and you never will.
Oh, and Rodney, I just got you to stare at my penis. Unbelievable.
Where have you been?
I was in the bathroom, having a heart-to-heart with your father. We talked, he threatened me, and stared at his penis the whole time. You know, typical future son-in-law, father-in-law kind of stuff.
Okay, honey, what's wrong with you? You're acting weird. You're sweating, you're pale. Are you sick?
No, I'm not sick. I'm just stressed out with work, stupid work stuff, okay? I've been meaning to tell you, it's just not the right place to tell you right here, you know?
What?
Look, something big went down at work.
Okay.
Well, why don't you share your big work news with everybody, Rodney?
Oh, no, that's all right, Jerry. No one wants to hear about that stuff.
Sure they do. I mean, especially if it's about your parking spot.
No, it's all right. Really, no one wants to hear.
Attention, everyone. Apparently, Rodney has some very big work news he'd like to share with all of us.
No, really, Jerry. It's really not. It's so boring. You don't want to hear about it. Party on.
Maybe it's okay. We're all family here. What is it?
Yeah, family, Rodney.
I got a promotion.
No, honey!
Yes.
Great! I'm so happy. Why didn't you tell me?
Oh, God, I wanted to surprise you. You know, yeah.
God. Oh, shit.
Still between when the high starts to fade. If the boys wanna die, you let them.
tell you one thing, you don't know how to type, you don't know how to fax, and I'll tell you why you can't do it later, because there ain't going to be a fucking later. You're a sorry piece of shit.
Balls hurt from spilling coffee, third-degree burns.
Well, at least your hands aren't covered in paper cuts from filing all day.
Oh my God, those are nasty. Get that checked out.
Rough week, girls? See you Monday.
I can't keep going on like this. There's got to be a better way.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. It's our only shot. Let's go.
Fuck.
Hey
guys, we're here for the book club. Jane invited us.
I did, but that was before Mike said that he likes to go to bars with, I don't know, what was it? Half-naked women swinging on poles.
Oh, no, he didn't. Ain't no half-naked women swinging around on no poles here.
Mm-mm. Cut one of these and I can make that happen for you, Betty. No, I will.
We just wanted to say that we realize that we've treated you pretty shitty over these years.
Oh, pretty shitty?
Okay, fine, very shitty. And we're really sorry for that. We had no idea how hard your jobs were until this week. Castro is making our lives a living hell.
We suck as secretaries.
Look at this guy's hands. Look at these paper cuts. We just really are at the point that...
We'd love to have a little bit of your help, please.
You look infected.
What do you think, Jane?
Well, maybe we could help. What's in it for us?
And anything you want. What can we help you with?
Yeah, what you got?
I don't want to hear it. I'm serious. I'm very upset right now.
Oh, come on. The Secretary League has some good players.
Don't even. This is some League of Their Own bullshit, and you know it.
See all my children yesterday? Come on, pretty girl. Right here, Tina. Come on.
Have they even won a game?
No, I don't think so.
Well, let's get this over with.
Oh, hi, honey.
Hey.
Hey, what are you doing home so early? I thought tonight was softball.
Yeah, it was. I just didn't feel like going out after, that's all.
Mm. That's a first. Oh, let me get these. Give me your uniform.
Oh no, I got these. They're just covered in mud. You don't want to touch them. What's all this?
Oh, sample wedding invitations. I think I have narrowed it down to the two that I like. Now these, I love the font for sure, but I don't know. It might be a little busy. And, honey, what do you think?
That's incredible. What is this, Helvetica?
That's a beautiful font.
What is it made from? Is it like? Papyrus?
You are so full of shit.
What?
Go watch the game.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're the best.
I know.
Can I get a kiss? All right, we'll do this tomorrow. Okay.
Saturday.
Don't turn your uniform pink again.
Well, it's your wedding. She wants you to be involved.
So I'm the worst fiancé of all time. I'm just not into this wedding planning stuff.
Use your imagination. Think of it as like a bitchin' party with neon lights and techno music.
Mikey, we're planning my wedding, not a frat party.
We get demoted and he gets a new car?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it's Ken Castro. Nope, just Ken. Wait, does it come in Ultra Deluxe? How about Super Ultra Deluxe? Hey, somebody want to pick up that sign? You know, Betty, there's a rule against eating at your desk, and let me tell you. If you worked as hard as you ate, maybe you'd get somewhere in life. Maybe. Unless, of course, your goal is to have your own gravitational pull and become the 10th planet, then congratulations, you're well on your way. We'll have to clear the desk out a little bit.
Hey, Castro, why don't you lay off, man? Come on.
Stay out of this, McAdams. This doesn't concern you. Why don't you and Murphy go jerk each other off in the copy room? Now, from now on, you eat only at lunch or on your break. You got me? Hey, do you got me?
Yes, Mr. Castro.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta go drop the kids off at the pool.
Why do you let him talk to you like that? You should stand up for yourself.
What am I supposed to do, Sue? I need this job. Besides, he ain't lying. Look at me. All I do is eat.
That's right, stretch it out.
Are you guys sure about this? I ain't never worked out before.
Come on, when we're done with you, you're gonna look like Star Jones.
And that's a good thing? She got all crazy when she got skinny.
Hey, you gotta take the good with the bad.
Shit. I guess I'd rather be crazy and skinny than fat and miserable.
There you go.
Okay, let's do this.
Right,
let's do this.
Sorry, girl. Come on, now go break a sweat.
Okay.
Ready?
Yep.
And go. There you go.
There you go. Light on your toes.
Take it easy at first. 23 minutes, 42 seconds. One more lap.
Lance Armstrong will be proud.
Good job, Betty. Run like a champion. That's just fun.
I like it.
You think we're pushing her too hard?
Nah.
Look at her. She's having a ball out there. Yeah. Looks like a wild stallion.
Oh, Lordy! Okay, people. Rules are going to be strictly enforced in this company now.
It is 8:58, people. That means you have 2 minutes to get inside and get to your desk, because we start at 9 sharp.
Oh, hey.
They're here.
Yes. Hey, Sun Yi, right?
It's Olivia.
Oh.
Mr. Castro.
Right? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Who's this old guy?
Oh, this is my son, Jack. I tried to get him a sitter for today, but she's in school.
So you're just going to bring him up to the office?
He's so quiet.
Yeah, he does look quiet. Hey, I got a great idea. Get that thing out of here. Move it. Get it back home. Get rid of it. All right, come on, folks. Let's move it.
Thank you very much. Have a great day. Hey, man.
Hey, man.
You're here like every freaking day. What gives?
Nothing gives. Why don't you put the bone down and go make some coffee?
You're like their coffee bitch?
What'd you just call me? Coffee bitch? That's funny. That's funny. Yeah, no, go ahead. Keep talking. Call me coffee bitch one more time. Go ahead. Go ahead. I will pole vault over this counter and shove a cappuccino up your ass.
You got it? No one calls me coffee bitch.
Whatever.
There he is. Coffee bitch in the house.
Oh, there's my little girl, favorite secretary. Why don't you take me a memo? Suck my cup. Oh, Jesus! I told you, double cup it. I have very tender fingers. I need two cups, you dumb dummy.
So long.
This better be decaf. You know, regular messes up my boner meds.
Oh, shit.
Hey, O'Donnell, I want that report on my desk in an hour. You got it?
What report?
Just do it, O'Donnell.
Shit, did I forget something?
Hi, honey. What are you doing here?
I don't know. I thought I'd, you know, stop in and surprise you. So which one's your new office?
Oh, baby. You don't want to see my office. It's so boring.
Do.
It's just, no, please. It's a desk. It's a chair. They painted it today. The fumes are nasty.
Wait, I don't care if they painted it.
Oh, no, but they're really bad. It's toxic. You'll faint. You'll faint. I promise. It's horrible in there.
Oh, God. Okay. If I can't see your office, then... let me take you to lunch.
Where's Nancy?
You know what? Today's really not so good for me. I've got a lot going on. I don't think...
But you can't take a lunch?
I'd really like to, but...
Mr. McAdams?
What?
They're looking for you in the conference room for your lunch meeting.
Oh, my lunch meeting. Of course. Thank you, Jane.
Uh-huh, sure.
Thank you, Jane. My lunch meeting. See, I've got this big lunch meeting. I'm sorry, honey. It's just not a good day.
I understand. Okay. Well, I will see you tonight.
Yes. Yes, you will.
Okay. Bye.
Bye. So, I'm gonna go back to work. I'm not gonna like it.
Rodney?
Yeah?
I'm so proud of you. I really am. The whole promotion and everything. I just wanted to tell you that.
Thanks.
Okay. Don't work too hard.
Bye.
That was one hell of a save back there, Jane. I mean, thanks for that. What a great bluff. I mean, these idiots should have you working in sales.
Oh, please. I've been trying to get in sales here for 10 years now. It'll never happen. In case you hadn't noticed, women don't get promoted in this company. Rodney, this is still an old-fashioned tire company. It's a boys' club. You know that. Your girlfriend doesn't know, does she?
Oh, no, that's my fiancé.
Oh.
Yeah. And I am gonna tell her. Maybe. But it's complicated. Her father wants to crush my nuts.
Well, that'll smart. She's your fiancé. Priorities. Take care of that, nuts and all.
Nancy, get in here and light my cigarette, you piece of shit!
Yes, sir!
Okay, this report is incomplete. And the pages aren't even in order. And is some of this written in pencil?
Well, the ink on my printer went out, so I don't know how to work the cartridge thingy.
You're unbelievable. Okay, yesterday you spilled a full box of paper clips into my paper shredder.
And
before that, you connected my conference call to a Chinese restaurant.
Ordering your Chinese takeout. And there were a lot of lines going, and one of them was a three-way call, and...
Okay, oh, you know what? Speaking of three-way, what about the porn that you synced to my BlackBerry?
Well, are you sure that wasn't already there?
Which, by the way, I cannot get off. Yes!
Excuse me, Miss Holland. Just wondering if I could borrow Mike for a minute. Got an errand I need him to run.
Don't you have your own secretary, Kenny?
Ken? It's Ken, and she's a bit preoccupied. I got her over at my place waiting for the cable guy. So.
Fine, go.
All right, clean the press this time, all right? And tell Rosario.
Don't push it, Kenny.
You don't push it. New secretaries, sometimes it takes a little bit to break them in, you know?
Not really. I don't send my secretaries out on personal errands.
Oh. Well, you should. It's fantastic. It's like having little elves, you know? All right, so, how's it going? How you liking Treadline? Fun group, huh?
Yes, very fun.
Yeah, we try to, you know, have fun.
Okay, bye-bye. Okay,
sometimes,
thanks.
You know, we'll go after work and we'll go to Ding Dong's and, you know, they have sports.
Thank you, no.
Oh, you gotta go. It's fun. I was gonna get a group of people. Maybe not even a group. You don't want to get overwhelmed. Why don't we go down, the two of us? Huh?
No.
Anyway, I'm over in that side of the hall and my door is always open to you.
Okay, could you close my door?
Yeah, yeah.
Thank
sure.
you.
I, you know, I meant that in like a spiritual way, so that it was like, you know, it's a symbolic thing. So the door may be closed, but hey, it's open to you.
You know, could you open the door? You out? Close? Thanks.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, you're busy.
Yes,
yeah, yeah.
Very busy.
Okay. Well, I will let you get to it. So.
Okay, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you, Ken.
Okay. Hey, do you like Greek food?
No, no. I don't eat.
Lamb?
No.
Vegetarian, huh?
Okay. Uh-huh. Bye-bye.
Ship up, shape out.
Ship out.
Do you, do you like movies?
No. No, I don't.
How about TV?
No.
All right. Well, if you get hungry...
Thanks. Bye-bye.
How you doing? You fixed good for cash?
I'm great. Yeah? Thank
okay.
you so much.
All right.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Okay.
This'll be it.
That's it.
Wow.
You should have seen her. I mean, she completely bailed me out.
Well, that's great for you. Meanwhile, my boss thinks I'm an idiot, and Castro's got me running around like his personal slave. Good news is, I've dropped like 2 sizes drinking this stuff.
Deserves a treat, you know, so I just gave him a quick hand job underneath his popcorn bowl. And then we went back to his house. And it was so amazing, you guys. We did it twice on the balcony. And the second time, he had me doggy style. And it was so beautiful. We were looking over the city lights. And at the exact moment he spooged, a shooting star went by. It was magical. Like a fucking Disney movie. But then I come in here today, and he completely ignores me. It's like he just used me for sex or something. Oh, guys, you're such jerks.
No, she's screaming, oh, O'Donnell, you're so big. And I'm like, damn straight I am. She's like,
O'Donnell, oh, but... O'Donnell, your ass is mine.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Don't what's up, us. We just finished having a little conversation with our friend Tina.
You remember who Tina is, don't you?
Come on, guys. I mean, that chick's a whore. Everybody in the office has boned her.
She's not a whore. She's an angel. Okay?
Here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna apologize, and then you're gonna buy her some flowers.
Yeah, big ones. 2 dozen red roses.
Do you have any idea how much that's gonna cost me?
Okay, man, just put down the stapler, man. Just put down the stapler.
And that goes for the rest of you clowns. Any of you mess with our girls, you'll have to deal with us. Hell yeah.
Maybe we can get her into like an AA program for women addicted to dick.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Like DA, Dicks Anonymous?
Yeah.
This is a great change of pace, Earl. Actually, do you mind if I call you Earl? Can I call you Earl?
Actually, no, you can't. See, Rodney, I ain't like other bosses. I like to get out of the office every once in a while and have some fun.
Oh, I love fun. Fun and me are like best pals.
Everybody, this is Rodney. Rodney, this here is the Killing Crew. Rodney, we're going to give you approximately, what do you think, boys, about 5 minutes? We're going to give you a 5-minute head start.
5-minute head start for what?
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Jesus Christ, what are you doing?
You're our prey today, son. You best get moving, boy.
Shit. Ow!
Nah. You know what? Fuck the 5 minutes. Let's go get some fresh meat, boys.
Hello?
Hey, where are you? It's lunchtime. I'm starving.
I'm about ready to eat this friggin' memo pad.
I'm not actually gonna make lunch today. I got a bit of a situation here, Mikey.
Are you running?
Yes, I'm fucking running.
Line him up!
Paintball? I don't know, it all just seems a little macho to me.
Honey, I told you it was a bonding exercise with my sales team.
Besides,
I'm their boss.
They have to know that I'm a great leader, that I can kick some ass, which, by the way, is exactly what I did.
Are you sure it wasn't the other way around?
Oh, these? Are you kidding me? You know what these are? These are defensive wounds, okay? I got these shielding my teammates.
Oh, okay, so you were like protecting them.
Yes. Yes, hell yeah.
That's hot.
Yeah, you like that?
It's really hot.
Really hot? You want me to show you exactly how I did it?
I do.
Okay, put the magazine down. Yeah, come.
Come here.
Get some of this paint.
Ow! Ow!
Oh, honey!
Ow!
Fuck.
Oh.
Oh.
No, no, it's not your fault. It's not your fault.
Can I get you some ice?
No, I need a nice suit. So let me get this straight. Your boss stalks you through the woods like a fucking ferret, and you're gonna tell Jennifer that it was a training exercise?
I had to tell her something. She's getting suspicious.
Whoa.
Oh. Whoa, whoa, uh-uh! Good morning, ladies.
Morning, Kenny. How's your ass? Was your boyfriend gentle on you last night?
Haha, you're a real comedian, Murphy. And it's Ken, goddammit. How many times I gotta tell you that?
Oh, we're sorry. How about fuckface? Does that work for you?
blow a horse, McAdams.
Nah, I'm good. I'll leave the animal rape to you.
It's not rape if you blow something. That's not rape.
What is with the roadblock? Does Treadline have some Al-Qaeda on the loose, or what's up?
You know, corporate asked me to make some cutbacks, so I thought I'd start with secretary parking. Yeah, these are all rental spaces.
Okay, where are we supposed to park?
All the secretaries are going to be able to park on Walnut.
Walnut? It's like a mile walk from here.
Castro, it's like 100 degrees outside today.
I know. It's a real scorcher, isn't it? Woo-hoo! I don't know if it's been this hot in a long time. Probably global warming. You should see what my nutsack feels like. All right. Have fun walking, bitches.
Castro's gonna pay for this like the fucking Sahara out here today.
Tell me about it. I'm definitely gonna have swamp ass all day now.
You and me both. My front side ain't doing too good either.
Yes, Miss Holland would like to know if she can reschedule her 2 o'clock, please.
There he is, right on time, going to take his morning shit.
Just like clockwork, this guy is so predictable.
Good morning, Mr. Frank's office. No, he's not in. Catch the message. Will do, thank you.
Wake it up, ladies. This isn't The View.
Hello, Mr. Castro's office.
He's in.
Gotcha.
Scientist? This shit's complicated.
Whatever, just turn them off.
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Don't mind me.
Okay. Excuse me. I just meant to take this with me on Friday. What are you doing here on a Saturday?
Just catching up on some work. Organizing. Nobody likes a sloppy secretary.
Right. Okay. Hey, are you hungry? Do you want to maybe grab some lunch?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Now?
good job!
When you said lunch, I didn't expect you to take me bowling.
Okay, first of all, despite this being a bowling alley, it happens to serve the best pizza in the city. And second, you know, I've been kind of hard on you. And lately, you've really stepped it up. So, I don't know, I guess it's the least I can do.
Thanks for this. It's really fun.
Yeah, it was fun. But listen, you know, you might not want to mention this to anybody in the office. Technically, I'm your boss.
Yeah, right, that's true. They might think that we were dating or something, or that you were trying to sexually harass me. Which, you know, which would, by the way, would be fine. I'd be totally cool with that. If, you know, I mean, I wouldn't tell anybody. I wouldn't report you.
Right. Good to know.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna get going.
Yeah.
Okay.
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 Okay. Come on. Oh, Jesus Christ, you didn't tell me he was coming.
Honey, he wants to be involved, okay? First of all, I didn't know you were coming. So I'll just try to get along today. Hi, Dad.
Hey, honey. How's my little girl?
Hey.
Let's go today, Rodney.
NASCAR style. Watch your head. Watch your head, sweetie.
Okay, all in?
Yep.
I hope you boys are ready, because we got a lot of shopping to do.
Come on, rookie.
Jesus, stop fucking hitting me,
come on.
He's done.
Don't mess with the big fella. About healing hearts, saving
lives, making all so. That's the one.
No. Hey.
Yeah, I like it. Yes. Okay, so, guys, we need to find a centerpiece. Centerpiece for the tables, that's what we're looking for, okay? Okay.
I got it first, Jared. Get your own.
No. I had it first.
What are you talking about? I got my hand on it first.
Don't mess with me, Rodney. I'm a war veteran.
What are you talking about? You were in the Coast Guard.
What do you mean by that?
Just give it. Oh my God, are you kidding me? This is a store, for God's sakes. You guys, is it possible for us to have one day, just one day, where you two get along?
Negative.
No. You can't keep arguing with your future father-in-law. It's not healthy.
What's not healthy is his ability to be such an asshole.
At least you're not falling for your boss, who, as it turns out, is cool as shit. Totally different outside the office.
What? The auditor chick? Really?
Yeah.
Most girls you date can't even add.
Yeah, I know. I don't know what's happening. I haven't wanted to go to a strip club in like 3 weeks.
But today is a big day for Treadline. Hell, I'd say it's the biggest day in this company's history. Any minute now, we're gonna get word that we have closed the Riley Auto Parts deal.
Yeah!
Who is the big dogs now? Get pumped! He's fired up! Yeah! I know, it's exciting stuff, huh? Yeah, I should know, I put the deal together myself. But I can pretty much imagine what you're all thinking, and I'll tell you what, I'll make it easy on you. You're welcome. I will be accepting cash and or gifts as tokens of gratitude for all the hard work I've done, huh? Now, wait, oh, I'm
A little low. You want to top me off? Come on, sugar bottom. You want to help me out? Yeah, honey buns, you. That's right. Get coffee for your boss. All right, now, who's got business they want to discuss?
Yeah, Ken. Seems we have an international kerfuffle.
Actually, I've got one quick thing. I don't know who it is that's been putting copies of the movie 9 to 5 on my chair, but it is really not cool. Not cool.
I said business, Murphy. Sorry, Klein, what were you saying?
Ken, listen, seems that...
Jesus Christ, McAdams. This is awful. What are you trying to do, poison me? Go to Bigby's, give me some real coffee. Hey, coffee bitch is making a run. Anybody want anything?
I need a decaf. We've already been over the reason. We don't need to talk about it.
Grab me a cappuccino.
Also, you know what, if you pass by...
Hey, look who's back for like a thousandth time. Let me guess, you want some coffee? Ain't that right? Coffee, bitch?
Really?
Who's the coffee bitch now?
Little shit blinded me with coffee grinds, right? So I grabbed this stale muffin and I hauled off a 90-mile-an-hour fastball. I nailed him right in the forehead and knocked his ass out.
Awesome. What's next? You gonna pick a fight with the retarded kid that works at Subway?
Shut up.
Those guys from corporate?
Misunderstanding.
I hope they fired Castro.
Not exactly, but they did chew him a new a-hole. Apparently, the Riley Auto Parts deal fell apart at the last second.
Oh, shit.
Take cover.
I know we call it the book club, but I didn't think we actually took it seriously.
Oh, no. No, it's not like that. I take nursing classes at night, and I've got a final coming up.
Oh, wow.
Well, that's nice. Oh.
Hey, can I ask you guys for some advice?
Yeah, sure. I mean, if it's about any kind of, you know, women's issues, you know, down there, we're not technically medically qualified to answer.
Please forgive him. He's a little slow. Go ahead. What do you need, shit?
See, I've got my anniversary coming up, and I have no idea what to get my husband. He's really difficult to shop for, and...
Low job.
Excuse me, did you just say...
Yeah, low job. You know, like Hummer, sucking off.
Giving head, smoking the bone, fellatio. It goes by many names.
And it's probably the best 5 minutes a man could ever ask for. That is what you should get him for your anniversary as a present.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's it?
That is it.
Look at that.
Wow, so, you know, I've been totally overthinking this whole thing.
Most women usually do.
But hey, no half-assing. You go downtown on that thing, okay? Like you did when you first started dating.
Yeah, lick his balls. It's an extra added bonus. Yeah,
balls. Ball licking is awesome.
You should be writing this down.
Okay,
licking his balls.
Ooh. Licking his balls?
Yeah.
The thing is, Bob and I, we're into making romance, and scrotum licking sounds like
no,
some
it's very romantic.
Crazy internet.
No. Romance, no. You build up to romance, and then you start going crazy.
Yeah,
you gotta like it, all right? And if you don't like it, you gotta pretend like you like it.
No, you gotta like it.
Because he's gonna love it.
Like, what do you like in life? What do you like to do?
Oh, I love antique shopping.
Antique shopping?
Yeah.
You gotta suck his dick like you are antique shopping. You know what I'm saying?
If you honestly, in your mind, if you concentrate really hard and make that cut like an antique, like the most beautiful antique you've ever seen.
Sure. You sure a brand new DVD player wouldn't be
better? No, fuck the DVD. No, you are a smart girl, okay? Yeah. Listen, bottom line, just suck that cock.
Yep, that pretty much sums it up.
Okay.
All right, but we need to go faster here, all right? I don't have to all day. Come on. Are you going? You gonna get that one down? Good. All right, guys. Also, hey, I asked for 10 guys, and they gave me 6, all right? I think one of them's gay, so 5.5. So
hey, what the hell's going on here?
More budget cuts. Castro's knocking down our break room. He says that it's an extra expense the company can't afford anymore.
Oh, come on, girl, don't cry. They took our coffee machine.
They're taking away all the slim fats.
Now I'm gonna get fat.
Brock, get me some more of these slag hammer things, and somebody bring me up my Maxim magazine.
Hey, Castro, you can't do this. You can't take our break room.
just did.
Beautiful here right now. What you're seeing is people who've decided they're not going to take it anymore. So, you know, we're just a bunch of girls out here fighting for our rights.
But you're a man.
I'm a man. Well, on the outside, that may be true. But here on the inside where it counts, we're all the same.
Ken!
Yeah.
Ken!
Yeah, what?
Ken!
Yeah.
There are no more fucking donuts!
This is a nightmare!
Ho, 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 ho! Take our shit, it's got to go!
That is uncalled for.
One of them just peed on the company flag.
Oh, not the seed. Not!
Castro wants to talk.
Oh, yeah, can't Castro come out here himself?
He's a little scared. Of them. And frankly, so am I. That's why I brought backup. And they're packing heat.
They're packing mace.
Hey, that shit'll burn your eyes out, Murphy. Don't you forget it, so back off.
Take it easy, Dirty Harry. Tell Castro we're coming in.
Yeah. I'm all right.
War by Ken Castro.
I wouldn't want to be in their shoes right now. Mike, always there to save Rodney's neck. I don't even.
Oh, my God.
So,
we did it!
We got the union!
because you helped me get this beautiful body, now you gotta give me some love. Woo!
TV, Rodney. He saw you. But you're a secretary? You told me that you got a promotion.
Yeah, well, I meant demotion, not promotion. I got caught up in the moment at the party, and after that weird talk with your father, I panicked. I'm sorry. I thought I could fix it before you found out.
Guess what, Rodney? You didn't fix it. I have never lied to you. Never. Never once have I lied to you.
I can't do this. I can't.
Sorry, man. It's a bummer. It sucks. I know. I've been there.
No, you haven't. You haven't been there.
Yes, I have. I've been there.
You haven't been there. Mikey, you've never had a girlfriend for more than 6 months.
Oh, come on. Dude, what about the chick from, you know, Sweater Puppies?
Katie Olsen?
Katie Olsen. Like, she dumped me senior year.
Senior year? Are you fucking kidding me?
What?
Are you kidding me? My marriage just fucking fell apart before it even started, and you're talking about senior year? How's that even close?
Well, I know how you're feeling. That deep pit in your stomach, that how that feels? I know how that feels. See, you're feeling that thought. I believe you. Where are you going?
I don't know. I'm gonna go try and find a place to live, because my fiancé, well, actually, scratch that, my ex-fiancé kicked me out of the fucking house.
Hey, Castro.
Hey!
Ken.
Rodney! Oh, you're looking really good there.
Listen, I really want my job back.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and Mike's, too. I mean, okay. Enough of this demoted stuff, okay? We get it. We totally get it, all right? You win, you're the boss. Look, I'll do anything you want, okay? I'll give you the commission on all my sales.
Rodney, you don't get it. There is no getting back your job. In fact, in 2 weeks, you're not even gonna have one.
What are you talking about?
Oh, yeah, because of that little stunt you pulled, Secretary's Union, I have to get back in corporate's good graces. Easiest way to do that? Agree to layoffs in the sales division. Boom, you and your little band of secretaries, first to go. Bye-bye.
Want to talk about it?
He's gonna fire us, Jane. All of us.
Doesn't that just figure? Castro screws up and we lose our jobs. This is every memo, every note, every email, every letter and contract pertaining to the Riley account. This was Farrell's baby. This is the biggest account in the country.
Jane, you're taking a big risk.
My girls are my life. If this can help save their jobs, I'm in.
Oh, hello there. What's your name? Oh, yeah? That's my name, too. Ken Castro likes what he sees.
Ken!
Oh, hey,
Ken!
Hey. God damn it!
Were you just looking at a picture of yourself?
I'm scrapbooking for taking an online scrapbooking course.
Well, listen, I just got off the phone with McPherson at Riley Auto. It seems Murphy, McAdams, and our girl Jane just went into a private meeting with Mr. Riley.
What the hell are they doing?
I don't know.
Well, we gotta get over there. Oh, get off me! Get off! Fine, thank you. Are broken. That's great.
Now, our earnings models also show that our overall value is expected to rise by the third quarter of next year.
Which, of course, will lower costs for our bigger suppliers.
I like the sound of that.
You can see that clearly graphed out here and here.
Yeah, and with this shaky economy, having our affordable tires on your shelves not only is good for your customers, but it's great for your business.
All right.
Go! Hey, it's that orange thing. Go.
Go. Oh, ridiculous.
Hey, Ken! Don't forget to validate. Thank you.
Ken Castro for Mr. Riley. Mr. Riley, don't listen to a word they say.
Kenny, I didn't think we had a meeting scheduled for today.
It's Ken, damn it. My fucking name is Ken.
Well, Ken, it seems that Treadline Tires will be in my stores after all. Thanks to your co-workers here. They did a hell of a job, and from what I understand, may have saved a few jobs in the process.
Well, no, you didn't make a deal with them.
Yes, I did.
But they're not, you can't.
See, Kenny, we did what apparently you couldn't. We closed the deal.
You know what, McAdams? I've enjoyed torturing you, I really have. It's been fun. But I think I'm gonna enjoy kicking your ass a little bit more. Come on, McAdams. Let's settle this right now. Come on.
Mikey, you wanna take this one?
Yeah, I got it.
All right. Oh, yeah, go ahead. Take the first one. Oh!
Shh. Yes, pretty solid punch for a secretary.
I'm getting the coffee.
Hey, what's going on in here?
Oh, hey, I'm glad you're back. We could actually use a hand.
Who's this?
Oh, this is Amy. Amy, meet Mike.
Mike.
Wait, so this is how it works? You fire me and then you bring in some temp agency trash to replace me? Wow!
What are you talking about?
Look at her, she's dressed like a hooker.
Mike, Amy's my sister, not a temp. Okay, audit's over. She was just helping me pack my things.
That's so great. Let me hold that, it looks heavy. There you go. Maybe sometime we could grab a drink since you're not officially like my boss anymore.
Drink sounds good. I heard Bennigan's makes one hell of a margarita.
What, are you kidding me? Benny's is the best in town. Actually, I have my own table, which is kind of cool, right?
Kind of.
Sorry about calling you temp agency trash and a hooker.
Uncalled for.
Bye.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, these are for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, listen, Jennifer, I don't even know where to... Oh, guess what? I got my old job back today, maybe even a promotion. Yeah, landed the biggest account in the country. Corporate had no choice.
That's great, Rodney. I'm happy for you.
What, that's it? I didn't do it for me, Jennifer. I did it for you. I did it for us.
God, Rodney, it was never about your job, okay? Secretary, sales associate, who cares? I don't care.
Your dad cared. You made that very clear.
But I wasn't engaged to my dad. He's not the one who lied to me. That was you.
You're right. And I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You have no idea. I swear. And I know I've said this so many times, but it will never, ever happen again.
Just stop.
No, no.
Just stop.
No,
it's fine.
I've changed. I'm a different guy now.
Just stop.
No, I don't want to. I'm not gonna stop. It's not fine.
It is
I'm
fine.
Different.
I don't
I've changed. Listen, I'm not gonna stop until I get you back, okay?
Just
no,
listen
no,
to me.
I'm not gonna stop until I get you. You know
it's
what?
It's fine.
And you remember?
Will you just listen to me, please?
Remember the promise I made? Remember that? I'm not gonna stop.
No,
I'm not gonna stop until I get you back. Because if you'll recall, I made a promise. Here it is. Promise? And I make good on my promises, sweetheart.
Rodney, what are you doing?
Let me tell you something. I love you. I love you so much, and now the whole world's gonna know. Jennifer Daniels, I love you. I love Jennifer Daniels! Hello, everybody. Hello, world. I love Jennifer Daniels. Aw, oh, Ed, Lucy, sweet little Lucy. I love Jennifer Daniels. Dougie, Oh, hello, Mr. Simpson. How are you today?
Hey, Robin.
I love Jennifer Daniels. On you go, sweet spirit. Oh, Nancy, Tom, if you knew how much I love Jennifer, if you knew.
I love her. That's nice.
I love her so much. I love Jennifer so much. Are you kidding me?
You don't need anything that big.
You guys enjoyed the show?
They were inside. They got here about 15 minutes before you did. I tried to tell you. They told me everything. They told me how much you've changed. They told me how much you've helped them. I'm so proud of you.
We thought you needed a backup plan.
I gave her the same advice you guys gave me.
I love you. And so do I. I love you.
Love you too.
I love you.
Could you show my butt with my shirt? I can tell Nancy's staring.
Yeah, sure. We need to find
a way. Oh, please come on my ass. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Rodney.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you, sir.
So, you really got the promotion this time, right?
Yes, I did. Don't, I promise. This time, I really got the promotion.
I'm proud of you, son.
Thank you, sir. Hi, sweetheart. Jesus, he is an animal, your father. Wow. Please hold me.
Have you in the Treadline family, Mr. Casey? I think you're going to be very pleased with our product. Closed another one. Oh.
It's going to be hard to keep up with you, Jane.
Hi.
Hey, happy bitch.
Oh, you know it. Sorry, I'm late. The guy at the coffee place is a real pain in the ass. As fast as I could. I don't know if you need to sleep. It's pretty hot.
Yes, absolutely. Mike and I plan on paying a personal visit to every store we sell to. Well, that's how we roll. Yeah, no, things have changed quite a bit around here. No. Mike and I are running the sales department now.
Hey, Rodney, did you get a chance to look at these?
Yeah. Yes.
Jesus, titty fucking Christ.
Yeah, he was a douchebag. I could not agree with you more. What's that? No, we couldn't fire Kenny. So we put him in charge of advertising.